are investigating the disappearance of Interpol's president. His wife reported him missing and says that she last heard from him 10 days ago. His whereabouts, a mystery. But a Hong Kong newspaper reports he's being questioned by authorities somewhere in China. CNN's Brian Todd has the latest for us.
He's a top leader of Interpol, the world-famous global crime-fighting agency. An elite law enforcement official well-versed in security measures. But now, a deep mystery surrounds Meng Hongwei, who has vanished from his post in France, missing for more than a week.
This is very strange because this is a very high-ranking position within Interpol.
Meng, a former top Chinese law enforcement official, was assigned to Interpol headquarters in Lyon, France. But a senior French law enforcement official tells CNN he was not on French soil when he was last seen. Meng's wife was the person who reported him missing. But even though he'd been missing for more than a week, she didn't tell police until Thursday night, French officials say. The French Interior Ministry says Meng's wife had recently received threats over the telephone and social media.
The wife is going to be the key. Obviously, when did she last talk to him? They'll look at whatever digital footprint he's got. They'll look at his email, his official email that he used at Interpol.
And there are questions about whether Meng Hongwei's disappearance is related to threats on his wife. Some reports say Meng returned to China, then disappeared. The South China Morning Post newspaper, known to have connections to Chinese authorities, cites an anonymous source saying Meng is under investigation for unspecified reasons and was taken away for questioning by so-called discipline authorities.
He may well have been picked up for questioning, not simply about what his activities may have been as a senior official at Interpol, but also what were his activities when as a senior official in China, where he likely has interacted with other senior officials, some of whom have been purged.
Analysts say the possibilities of what happened to Meng and what he may know are almost boundless, given the world he came from, the cunning and ruthless Chinese security apparatus.
Any intelligence community, any especially internal security force, is always going to be deeply suspicious of everyone, because especially in the Chinese context, where you are policing 1.3 billion people, where you have to worry about not just actual conspiracies, but internet-based conspiracies, criminal activities. The people who are very senior officials in this are aware of the habits and tendencies of a vast swath of the population. This is a country where the right to privacy is not even a figment.
The Chinese government so far has not commented on this case. Analysts say if Meng Hongwei was brought back to China for questioning, we may not find out what happened to him for quite some time, probably until some brief announcement by the Chinese government about possibly some kind of punishment. Brian Todd, CNN, Washington.
Brian Todd on the story, thank you. And now CNN senior producer Stephen Zhang is following the story live in Beijing this hour. Stephen, thank you for your time today. Why is China not saying anything, and what is the importance of his role there?
Well, George, probably because the political sensitivity surrounding this case, as we speak, actually when Brian's story was on air, CNN signal was actually being blacked out by Chinese censors here. So viewers in China actually did not get to watch the story and did not get to watch us, are not able to watch us talk right now. That's the kind of sensitivity surrounding this case. And the Chinese state media has also stayed away from the story entirely. On social media, even though Meng's name has not been entirely censored, any mention of his disappearance has been scrubbed clean. In terms of why? Well, because even though there's no official confirmation, all signs pointing to that his vanishing act is a result of an internal party investigation. It really bears hallmarks of what happens to senior Chinese officials when they are suspected of violating the Communist Party's regulations, including corruption and utter wrongdoing. Now, President Xi Jinping, the Chinese leader, of course, has been trying to rid the party of corruption and clean up the party since he took power. It's very popular with the people, his campaign, but also very controversial because of the methods and tactics deployed by his party investigators. They're known to snatch people away, holding people incommunicado for months at a time, and even use torture to extract confessions. And the whole process is really shrouded in deep secrecy. So things really are not looking good for Mr. Meng on right now, George.
All right, Stephen. And look, this is not the first high-profile disappearance involving a Chinese national. In recent weeks, a high-profile actress also mysteriously disappeared. Tell us more about that, if you could.
That's right. That's also a fascinating and some would say terrifying story, George. Fan Bingbing, one of the country's most famous and highest paid actresses, often compared to Jennifer Lawrence, she vanished into thin air back in June. And we did not find out what had happened to her until a few days ago when the government announced that she had been placed under investigation for massive tax evasion. She was found guilty and ordered to pay back taxes and fines totaling about $130 million. So it was that kind of examples, that kind of cases really illustrates how murky and how non-transparent the system here, the political system, the legal system here is. And that really does not bode well for Mr. Meng, George.
Stephen Jiang, following the story live for us in Beijing. Thank you for the reporting.